We will defy conventional science and gravity by bouncing the ball much higher than you would imagine. The smaller ball becomes super bouncy, going almost 9 times or about 18 feet. Let us play with our super bouncy tennis ball and understand the physics behind this magic.
So all we need a few balls of different sizes, and to place them on top of the other so that they are stable, we have made these rings, which you can make them from wall tubes.
When I drop a single ball from about 4 feet, it retains about 70% of its speed after striking the ground. Hence, it bounces back almost half its original height to about 2 feet, which is 0.7 times 0.7. But when I bounce two of them together, something interesting happens.
We'll take this football, and on top of that, we place this small ring, on top of which we will place this tennis ball. And we'll make sure that they are aligned such that their center is all passing through a straight line.
Every moving object has a momentum, which is its mass multiplied by its speed. And in case of a collision, the total momentum of colliding bodies is same before and after the collision. Now, football weighs 6 times the tennis ball, so its momentum is 6 times more. After striking the ground, tennis ball basically takes half the momentum of the football. So the football now bounces less, from 2 feet to 1 feet, and tennis ball bounces more. Since the tennis ball is about 6 times lighter, its speed increases 3 times. So it goes 9 times the distance, from 2 feet to 2 times 9, which is 18 feet. Remember, when the speed doubles, the ball goes 4 times.